Hello guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new to my channel, hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Summer. So today's video, I wanted to talk about what happened in Borno State. And for those that do not know, I will put a link. You can go read the full article, so you can get the real picture of what happened, and then maybe you can understand how sad what happened, is. Long story short, farmers in Borno State were just deleted. When I say deleted, right? Like, if you read the article, the way they deleted them, if you know what I mean by the word delete. Like, I'm not trying to exaggerate. They tie them up. You know the way people tie up chicken and cut the throat? That is exactly what they did, okay? And then I thought about the fact that this Boko Haram thing has been going on for way, way too long. I made a video where I said, I do not believe that the government wants to end Boko Haram. I don't believe it, right? And I recently started thinking about how, if you really think about it, it is more profitable or better to be a Boko Haram member than to be an NSAS protester. If you know what I mean. I'm not saying this as a suggestion that, oh yeah, go and be a Boko Haram member, rather than be member of NSAS. But I'm saying it as a statement of fact. When I say fact, what do I mean? This is how it appears. This is what we see in front of us. Sadly, it is what we see in front of us. What am I really talking about? Till date, Nigeria has not been able to do anything about the sponsors of Boko Haram. But we all know what they did to the sponsors of NSAS. Government is not doing anything about the Boko Haram. But they can come and clamp down at the NSAS protesters. For those that do not know, or for even those that know, but let me lay it down for it to be a bit clearer, right? This is Boko Haram. People that have been deleting Nigerians. Innocent Nigerians going to work, going to school, we know about the Chibok girls. All they did was go to school. He came there and took them away. And this Boko Haram has done so much evil in the land, so much to the innocent citizens. They have made life impossible for so many people. And then NSAS protesters, all they've done is to come out and say, we as Nigerians want to be able to be free in our own country. We want an end to police brutality. NSAS protesters have not harmed anybody. They have no guns, no weapons, nothing. Absolutely nothing, right? And then look at the two of them and look at how the government have treated. In comparison, you see how they are being treated. I was shocked when I found out that Boko Haram, so-called repentant members, are being sent abroad. They even hold ceremonies for them. They have so much benefits. These are people that have actually done something bad. They benefit from the taxpayers' money for doing what? For committing atrocities. And then NSAS protesters are just coming out to ask for their simple right to be respected. Respect my right to have a life. My right to walk on the street without being attacked by the police. Respect my right as a Nigerian citizen. That is all they are asking for. And then the government sends soldiers. The government equipped the soldiers to go attack, to go pounce at peaceful protesters. Just think about these two, right? NSAS protesters, peaceful, waving flags, doing nothing, no evil. And then they get dealt with this way. And then Boko Haram members have actually been flown abroad for education. Boko Haram members are getting free foreign education. Take a minute and compare these two things. Cracks down on NSAS protesters alleging terrorism. NSAS protesters are called terrorists while we still have Boko Haram. I made a video where I showed how equipped the soldiers were, the police were, to go face peaceful protesters during the NSAS rally. And then when you hear about the Boko Haram, the soldiers that are being sent to Boko Haram, you find out that they were never equipped. They were basically being sent over, basically being sent to the forest to go lose their lives in the hands of Boko Haram. NSAS promoters were being arrested, their accounts being frozen. And this happened within a few days. Boko Haram has been existing for how long now? Till date, no account has been frozen. Till date, none of their promoters have been arrested. I just want people to take a minute and think about this country we call Nigeria and see for yourselves what is really going on. In case you have not noticed, to make it more obvious to you that there is so much that is going on. Buhari have said that ENSAs will never happen again. Buhari was saying putting an end to ENSAs. You know, there was another article I saw that really, like, you know, they say Nigerian president calls for the end to protest against police brutality. Listen to that very well. He is calling for the end of the protest against police brutality. He's not asking for the end of police brutality. No, he's asking for the end of the protest against it. He has vowed that there will never be another ENSAs, but he has not vowed and ended the Boko Haram. Another area I want to address is this. Let me tell you, Nigeria is supposed to be a sovereign nation, right? So if in our own country, our government cannot defeat a group of people, so what's going to happen then if another nation was to fight against Nigeria? What does that mean? That Nigeria cannot even fight a war? Are you telling me that if Nigerian government was to really, really prepare the Nigerian soldiers to go to this Sambisa forest, that they cannot finish Boko Haram? Do you believe that for a second? I don't know why I don't believe that. From all the killings and everything they've done, yet they don't even seem to be a priority. What ordinary small answers that Nigerians did, do you know how much effort the government have put towards ending the ENSAs protest? From there, the government has vowed there will never be another ENSAs. Laye Mohammed have already come up with there's going to be a social media bill or media bill or whatever. They have done so much to make sure that they shut up or shut down the everyday Nigerian. The innocent everyday Nigerian, the everyday Nigerians that have the right to make these demands, that have the right to speak up. They have done everything to make sure that they prevent people from sorosokeying. I want people to think about these things. Look at the amount of effort they have put towards ending the ENSAs protest. And then you look at the lack of effort they've put to ending Boko Haram. If the picture is not clear, I really hope it's getting clearer to a lot of us as Nigerians what is really going on. You would see how hopeless this situation really is. A country where the criminals, the terrorists are being rewarded and the innocent citizens are being punished. And with that, I'm going to say thank you for watching. Until the next time, guys. Bye-bye. Bye.